After messing with Greece, France and UAE, Erdogan has earned Turkey another major enemy, Mossad. And it's one enemy that Turkey does not want. Turkish President Erdogan is getting surrounded on all sides by waging back-to-back proxy wars in Syria and Libya and harassing Greece. Turkey has already antagonized the Western world and made enemies out of Greece, Cyprus and France in the Eastern Mediterranean and Saudi Arabia and UAE in West Asia. But now Ankara faces a new enemy, which is incidentally a deadly player in both regions, and that's Israel and its top intelligence agency, Mossad. This comes in the backdrop of Erdogan's recent call to liberate the Al-Aqsa Mosque in East Jerusalem. According to the Times, the head of Israel's intelligence agency, Mossad, Yossi Cohen, said that Turkey is a bigger threat than Iran while talking to his Egyptian, Emirati and Saudi counterparts. This comes as a major setback for Turkey because Mossad, which has for several years successfully challenged the Iranian leadership's resolve to obliterate, now seems to be targeting Turkey. Mossad could do to Ankara what it has been doing to Tehran all this while. Mossad is known for alleged assassinations of nuclear scientists and for sabotaging Tehran's nuclear facilities and supplying Iran with faulty material through bogus companies to mess with Iran's nuclear weapon ambitions. But it seems that Israel and its elite intelligence agency is now reassessing its threat perception in the context of Iran's weakening stature and Turkey's increasingly belligerent behavior in the Eastern Mediterranean. As per the Times, Cohen's point was not that Iran had ceased to be an existential menace, but rather it could be contained through sanctions, embargoes, intelligence sharing, and clandestine raids. Turkey's coercive diplomacy, its sloppily calculated risk-taking across the Middle East, posed a different kind of challenge to strategic stability in Eastern Mediterranean. Israel faces two primary threats from Turkey: belligerence in the Eastern Mediterranean and extensive Turkish support for Palestine and the terror organization in Gaza, Hamas. Turkey is the only country that has disputes with all its maritime neighbors in the Eastern Mediterranean and regularly crosses swords with Greece, Cyprus, Egypt, and Israel to pursue its own extraterritorial claims in the region. Moreover, Erdogan is using his influence over the Muslim Brotherhood regime in Libya to make an absurd interpretation of the international maritime law and steal Greek maritime space. Turkish advances into the Eastern Mediterranean threaten Israel's interests for two reasons. One, Israel's location in the Eastern Mediterranean, and two, Tel Aviv's growing role in the troubled region. Last month, the Israeli cabinet approved a pipeline deal, which is the East Med, to move gas offshore via Cyprus to Greece and Europe. Needless to mention, the 1,900-kilometer-long gas pipeline project connecting Europe to the Eastern Mediterranean basin gas field militates against Turkish expansionism in the Eastern Mediterranean. Israel and Turkey are therefore on a collision course in the resource-rich region. Israel threatens to spoil Turkish research and exploration activities in the Greek and Cypriot waters, as the East Med project is going to operate in more or less the same area. In fact, Israel has already started backing Greece against Erdogan. Israel-Greece military ties have been deepening, with Greece signing a deal to lease Israeli drones and the Israeli Air Force fighter aircraft participating in a Greek military exercise. Strategic circles in Israel are also giving a lot of importance to strengthening military ties with Greece. Moreover, Israel's Prime Minister Netanyahu has himself said that Israel-Greek ties are expanding partly because of the shared geopolitical interests of the two democratic countries in the Eastern Mediterranean. He added, "Of course, we take any aggressive actions in the Eastern Mediterranean seriously from any actors, including Turkey." Israeli-Turkish relations have also hit a low point because Erdogan cannot conceal his Islamism. First, he made enemies in the West by reconverting the ancient Roman cathedral turned mosque turned museum Hagia Sophia into a mosque. And now Erdogan wants to reaffirm his image as a liberator of mosques with the liberation of the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem. The Al-Aqsa, or Temple Mount compound, remains an emotive issue for Jews. being the site of the two historic temples in Jewish tradition. Therefore, Aradwan's fetish to relive the Ottoman brutality has rubbed Israel the wrong way by raking up Al-Aqsa. Moreover, Israel also understands that Turkey and Iran are the biggest sponsors of Hamas, the terrorist faction of Palestine fighting an existential battle against Israel. While Iran remains crippled by sanctions, Mossad seems to believe that Turkey is the biggest threat. For decades, Iran was the biggest threat for Israel, while Turkey was a NATO member in the Eastern Mediterranean, and therefore not much of a threat. But Erdogan's Islamist turn is creating new enemies for Turkey, and it seems Israel is going to add up to Ankara's wooze.